The God of all grace has blessed us this day. All of creation joins us in praise, lifting our voices, lifting our hearts to the glory of God forever. God of power and might, come into our presence this day. Strengthen us now with the Spirit of faith. We gather in your name. The God of all grace has blessed us this day. All of creation joins us in praise, lifting our voices, lifting our hearts to the glory of God. God of mercy and truth, who brings us from night into day, nourish our lives with the Spirit of hope and shield us from all fear. The God of all grace has blessed us this day. All of creation joins us in praise, lifting our voices, lifting our hearts to the glory of God forever.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our Mass here at Mission Basilica San Buenaventura. In today's gospel, even the demonic recognize Jesus as the Son of God, a Holy One from God. So as we come together, already baptized, already cleansed, already remade new, may we recognize Jesus among us here at this altar, in this Eucharist, in this spiritual communion with him. For we proclaim Jesus is the Holy One of Israel, the incarnate God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the Holy and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, Jesus is the Holy One. He is the Son of God. He is the Messiah, and he offers us salvation. And at the beginning of Mass, Holy Mother Church, in this beautiful liturgy, dispenses that grace that Jesus has entrusted to her so that we would be cured from those little infirmities, those venial sins, so that we may be worthy to celebrate these sacred mysteries. So let us ask the God of mercy and healing and peace to have mercy on us. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, to take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory
bow our heads in prayer and recollect our personal intention for this Holy Mass. Grant us, O Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to all the people, saying, "A prophet like me will the Lord your God raise up for you. From among your own kin, to him you shall listen. This is exactly what you requested of the Lord your God to Horeb. On the day of the assembly, when you said, 'Let us not again hear the voice of the Lord our God, nor see this great fire any more, lest we die.' And the Lord said to me, 'This was well said. I will raise up for them a prophet like you from their kin, and will put my words into his mouth. He shall tell them all that I command him. Whoever will not listen to my words, which he speaks in my name, I myself will make him answer for it. But if a prophet presumes to speak in my name, an oracle that I have not commanded him to speak, or speaks in the name of other gods, he shall die.' The word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
Let us come. come into his presence giving thanks. Let us hail him with a song of praise. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Oh, come, let us bow and bend low. Let us kneel before the God who made us. For he is our God, and we the people who belong to his pasture, the flock that is led by his hand. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as on that day at Massa in the desert, when your forbearers put me to the test, when they tried me, though they saw my work. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I should like you to be free of anxieties. An unmarried man is anxious about the things of the Lord, how he may please the Lord. But a married man is anxious about the things of the world, how he may please his wife, and he is divided. An unmarried woman or a virgin is anxious about the things of the Lord, so that she may be holy in both body and spirit. A married woman, on the other hand, is anxious about the things of the world, how she may please her husband. I am telling you this for your own benefit, not to impose a restraint upon you, but for the sake of propriety and adherence to the Lord without distraction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Then they came to Capernaum, and on the Sabbath Jesus entered the synagogue and taught. The people were astonished at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as scribes. In their synagogue was a man with an unclean spirit. He cried out, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus rebuked him and said, "Quiet, come out of him." The unclean spirit convulsed him and with a loud cry came out of him. All were amazed and asked one another, "What is this? A new teaching with authority. He commands even the unclean spirits, and they obey him." His fame spread everywhere throughout the whole region of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
That second reading from St. Paul today, the beginning of it especially is very appropriate for us. We are anxious about many things, are we not? I mean, in all truth, we're perplexed what's going on with the world, with politics and that, but more specifically, we're perplexed about this coronavirus, and we're anxious about it. I know some people want to come together for Mass, and some parishes are offering that. But I'm anxious about it too. You know, this last week I was twice called to Community Memorial Hospital, anointed, some physically and some distance, and offered last rites. And now we have two funerals this week for Frank Duran on Friday and for Alicia Terran on Saturday. Beloved Kathleen Antogiovanni succumbed to the COVID and complications and went to heaven yesterday. And the list goes on and on. So even as this coronavirus is manipulating itself and coming in various strains, I am not going to bring us together. I'm sorry, I can't do it. You want to gather together? Wonderful. But you can't bring us together presently. I hope that we will soon. But, and on my years of teaching, students would use various slang words, and I would finally pick them up, and I was usually a little bit Johnny-come-lately on them. So I know this is a word that's a little bit beyond its time, but I am stoked. I am stoked for all of us, because just this last week, we subscribed to a platform called Formed. Now, there's over 5,000 parishes in the English-speaking world that have subscribed to Formed, or bilingual parishes like ours, because there is a Spanish platform in that. Formed offers thousands of books and movies and programs of spiritual enlightenment for our Catholic community. The parish has subscribed to it, so it's free for you, unless you choose to purchase something, but you can download them. If you have a smart television, you can download it and have movie nights or program nights or spiritual enlightenment or Bible studies. All of those things can be downloaded to a smartphone, to a computer, to your tablets, to your phones. It's free to you because we have subscribed to it. So if you go to our website, and you will see on the right-hand side blue letters Formed, all you need to do is click that on, put in our zip code for the parish, select our parish, you are enrolled. And so hopefully that will relieve some of the anxiety and in that the fact that you can watch with families, with adults, various movies, some of, I said, spiritual enlightenment and faith and theology, as well as entertainment. And so we bring that to you as a gift during this time of separation. And also I'll be sending a letter to all our parishioners who are registered within the next week or 10 days outlining our Lenten program for you. Various programs of virtual Stations of the Cross, Adoration, of course, Mass, and different liturgies to keep you connected to your Mission Basilica parish, to your Catholic family, but socially distanced so that we're not anxious about contracting this disease. You know, we are people of faith. We know who Jesus is, and we know what he is about. But in that gospel that Deacon Mark just proclaimed, what a vivid account of Jesus. I love these historical stories, faith stories, stories of the truth of Jesus as he lived and what he did. Jesus the teacher. He's in the temple. And what is he doing? He's doing an exorcism. Yes, he's telling that evil spirit to come out, an evil spirit to come out of a man that had been possessed. What is your reaction to this stunning event? Imagine yourself sitting there in the temple. Imagine yourself sitting in the church, the Basilica Church, San Buenaventura Mission, and Jesus is standing there. And he says to an evil spirit that was causing convulsions in the man, come out. And what does that evil spirit says? He says, I know who you are. Really? The evil spirit knows who Jesus is? Some may think the man's condition was described as a diabolical possession simply because the people of that time did not understand mental illness or epilepsy or other medical conditions, and they assumed that his behavior must be to indicate an evil spirit according to the customs of the day. That may be true. But that's kind of watering down the reality of who Jesus is. It's offering an explanation in terms that take away the spiritual nature of what Jesus, the teacher, the Lord, the God, the incarnate Son, what he did. Others will approach these things quite in a literal way and believe that the possession is more common affliction in the modern world than most people realize. You and I, brothers and sisters, we do well to acknowledge that the power of evil certainly exists and is manifest in the world in many different ways. But I'm not afraid of it, and neither should you be. We might be a little anxious, but we know who is in charge, and we know what Jesus will do. Just watching the evening news on television will tell you this much, that there's evil in the world, that people do evil things. And some will say, why does God allow that? God allows it. God allows us a freedom to do good things or evil things. That's the wonder of God. God doesn't control us and manipulate us. Otherwise, we wouldn't have the freedom that God has called us as sons and daughters, as brothers and sisters. He gives us within our conscience, within our own being, and through the sacraments of the church, the ability to choose between right and wrong. Reason. But some people choose the dark side. And so there is evil in the world. What else can explain some of the horrendous things that occur, other than that perpetrators have given in to the power of evil? Deep-seated selfishness and hatred are not the work of God. No. Nor can they ever be remotely in the interest of any human well-being. God does not do this to us. We do it to ourselves. And although it is important to understand that God does not create evil, we must realize, this is truth, that angels and men can and do reject Christ and the goodness that he represents, and this is the route to considerable damage to the individual and to others. There are fallen angels, there are fallen members of our human race, but you and I are called to be children of light, to follow the way, the path to Jesus. Oh, we may stumble once in a while, but we are centered in the way. What I find particularly interesting in the gospel account is the demons' reaction to the presence of Jesus. They're in the temple. This man is convulsing. Jesus said that evil spirit, hey, out, be gone. And the disturbance took place. And since that place was in the context of a solemn liturgy like this, they were worshiping in the temple, the normal course of events disturbed man would probably have been quickly hustled out. You know, sometimes it happens downtown, and a person that has mental illness or homeless for some reason, they'll come in. Many come in just sit and watch and listen and quiet, but some come in with a disturbance, and our ushers, rightfully, for the sake of the liturgy and for the well-being of invite that person out of the church. However, before this happened in the temple in today's gospel reading, the demon calls out and acknowledges Jesus. I know who you are. You are the Holy One of God. Isn't it ironic that it seems to take a possessed man to recognize the sheer goodness of Jesus? And you and I, we can do it without being possessed. We can do it by what we say, what we do, how we think, how we move, how we act. Even if this was because he represents a terrible threat to the powers of darkness, that evil spirit realized that. He was doomed. He recognized that Jesus was the Holy One of God. And we have already been told that the people in the synagogue were already impressed with Jesus. Hey, this Jesus, he's a great teacher. He unveils the scriptures for us. He makes it relevant to us. He helps us understand. He gives us hope and mercy. But they do not go beyond that at that moment. And so Jesus performs this powerful act. Then suddenly he recognized by the demon for who he truly is, the Son of God. Now think about that for a moment, won't you? It is not just Jesus' teaching authority that is recognized, but his spiritual nature. You are the Holy One of God. He makes a deep impression on men, but even more on evil spirits. They recognize him. They fear him. They flee from him. Right here at the beginning of the gospel, Jesus is beginning to be acknowledged as the Messiah, the prophet that Moses talked about in that first reading, the Holy One of Israel, the Holy One of God. And so St. Mark, the author of today's gospel, has established earlier in the gospel the teaching authority of Jesus. It was already assumed for his readers. But now comes this incident in Capernaum, where Jesus is again acknowledged by the people for his authority as a preacher and teacher, and of course recognized for who he is by that demon. And so Mark wants us to be clear about who Jesus is, that he indeed is the one, the true Savior of the world, that the order for us to be saved, we need him. We believe him, and we follow him in the gospel teaching of love. That is the way. That is the way to salvation. And no pandemic can take that away from us. No anxiety can separate us from the love of God. For St. Mark, the gospel is fundamentally about freedom, true freedom. Just yesterday, someone said, how come God's allowing these things to happen? I said, hello? Hello? God's not allowing these things to happen. He's not making them happen. He's allowing them in the context of giving us a free will, yes. That we can put on God. But what's happening, people doing things, that's on them. And that's on us when we do it or fail to do it. Sins of omission and commission. He is the one, Jesus, is the one who can release us from all that binds us, all that holds us down and holds us, keeps us down, all from our inner demons, those little things that creep in, which we frequently call venial sin and sometimes more significant, mortal sin or grave sin.
that sinfulness. He is our liberator. The very deepest sense of that word, liberation. Jesus is the one who can restore us to life and grace and enable us to walk the way. Walk the way as disciples, as missionary disciples, in our domestic church, in our Holy Mother Church, in our community, in our world, that brings us to unity with God. When you and I daily recognize that Jesus is the Messiah, Jesus is the Son of God, that Jesus has come to save us, and we live by that freedom, we are saved. This is true freedom. This is us exercising the choice to be what God wants us to be. Recall, my sisters and brothers, recall at the end of the Gospels, the end of Jesus' human life here on earth, his incarnation. As he hung on the cross, portrayed right here, even in this auditorium, this beautiful crucifix that actually hung in the chapel at Camarillo State Hospital for decades, and now it's here, as he has portrayed Jesus there, as he hung upon the cross, another complete outsider, whom you wouldn't expect to know anything, a centurion soldier, a Roman, an official of the representative of the Roman Empire. Remember in the gospel what that centurion says as Jesus dies? He recognizes who Jesus is, who he really is, and expresses himself in these immortal words. You know them. Truly, this man was the Son of God. My sisters and brothers, today and always, these words can be made our own. Truly, you are the Son of God. These words can save us. They can give us hope, freedom, liberation, and life eternal. These words are our greatest protection against all that is evil. We know who you are, the Son of God. As I gave the last rites to Frank Duran and to Kathleen Antogiovanni in these last few days, they knew who Jesus was. They acknowledged who Jesus is in their life. They now have that eternal realization in forever with Jesus. May you and I proclaim by what we say and do that you are the Son of God. And therein lies our freedom and our life eternal, the way.
And so now let us stand, and I say this every week, but you'd be surprised that several people that come to communion right after this Mass in the garden said, oh, we heard it, we were at our desk or in our bed, and you said stand for the prayer of the faithful, and they did, so stand. It's one way of being united and in union with each other. It's one way of saying, Jesus, you are the way, you are the life, you are the truth, through the Trinity of profession. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He has ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trust this, believe this, that our faithful God watches over his flock. Confident in his everlasting kindness, let us present our prayers this morning.
For the church, that all who proclaim and teach the word of God may do so in truth and humility, with an affirming word of loving service, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders throughout the world, that they watch over those whom they serve, and for peace and unity in our country, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from the coronavirus, for their doctors, caregivers, and families, and for an end to the pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those burdened by emotional or mental illness, may they know God's love and be sustained in hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in our parish community who are ill or homebound, especially Ed Pierce,
Ed,
Cicely Ramirez,
Cicely,
Ralph Ellis,
Ralph,
Cheryl Conway,
Cheryl,
Suzanne Farmer,
Suzanne,
Mary Lou Roberts,
Mary Lou,
Ishmael and Tony Gonzalez,
Ishmael and Tony, Gabriel Martinez,
Gabriel.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sisters and brothers who have died in faith, especially Annette Aldachin,
Annette,
Coco Ballard,
Coco, Kathleen Antogiovanni, Frank Duran.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts,
Lord, hear our prayer. God of compassion, you sent your Son to teach us your ways and to be the way to you. Hear our prayers that we may heed his voice and be faithful and worthy followers of his ways. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Give us, O Lord, the bread of your word. Give us the bread of your table. Be in our prayer, be in our labor, as we seek to do your seek to do. Speak to our hearts, O risen Lord. Words that will burn within, giving us courage for the call. Come and follow me. Give us to do your will.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed Holy One, the Holy O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Archbishop, Robert, our Auxiliary Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep from the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, yes, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with our blessed patrons, Buenaventura, Junipero Serra, Cari Tecahuetha, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Sisters and brothers, at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray. We pray, deliver us from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you, brother. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
There is nowhere on earth I can escape.
Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The announcements for our Mission Basilica community, for those joining us by live stream, Holy Communion is offered in the Basilica Garden on Sundays between 10 a.m. and 11 a.m. If you know of a parishioner who is or has been infected with COVID and would like to receive prayers from the parish community, please call and inform the parish office. Registration is open for the 2021 University Series. Virtual presentations will be offered Monday through Friday during Lent. This series connects faith with real life areas such as current events, contemporary moral issues, marriage, family, scripture, and prayer. View the course catalog and register at the link found in the bulletin and on the Facebook page and our website. The last day to buy a season pass is February 19th. Next weekend is the first weekend of the month and the Catholic Charity Food Pantry Collection. We are very grateful for your generosity. First Friday Masses on February 5th are 7:30 a.m. in English and 7:30 p.m. in Spanish, followed by Adoration until 10 p.m. For more updates and information, please visit our website where you can find today's bulletin.
We know who you are. You are the Holy One of Israel. You are the Son of God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Glorify the Lord.